الحمد لله رب العالمين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله ولي الصالحين وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلوات الله وسلامه عليه. My respected brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, من جاء بالحسنة فله خير منها وهم من فزع يومئذ آمنون ومن جاء بسيئة فكبت وجوههم في النار هل تجزون إلا ما كنتم تعملون. In this verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has divided mankind into two. He says, anyone who comes on the day of judgment with good deeds, Allah has promised you two things. And these two things are one, that every good deed, you get 10 rewards. And the second promise is that Allah will give you protection from the hellfire. Then he said, وَمَنْ جَاءَ بِسَيِّئَةٍ anyone who comes on the day of judgment with a bad deed, فَكُبَّتْ وُجُوهُهُمْ فِي النَّارِ Allah says he throw them on their faces in the hellfire, and it will be announced to them that you are being put in the hellfire as a punishment for what you earned, what you have done in this world. Brothers and sisters in Islam, so we have to understand what are good deeds and what are bad deeds, so that we can do the good and abstain from evil. The scholars are saying that the good deed in this verse means bearing witness that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is one and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the messenger of Allah. The word of Tawheed, the oneness of Allah, that you make sure that in your heart there is no one or there had never been anyone but your creator, who is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In your prayer or in your worship, in your dealings, in everything that you do in this world, you have to have in the back of your mind that the one who created you is Allah, the one to whom you are going to return is Allah, and the one that sustains you, that you live and life in this world, is Allah, and He alone deserves to be worshipped. So all your worship, all your good deeds are to be directed to your creator, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is the highest of good deeds that you can perform. Due to that, people are divided into three categories. We have those who come on the day of judgment, they have only good deeds, no bad deeds. These ones are declared people of paradise. Then we have the second group. They come on the day of judgment, they have no good deeds, they have only bad deeds. These ones are declared the people of hellfire. Then comes where we belong. Those who come with good deeds and bad deeds. To this, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as Allah says in the Quran, وَالْوَزْنُ يَوْمَئِذٍ الْحَقُّ, that on the day of judgment, the scale is true. Allah is going to place all the deeds that we have performed or deed done in this world on the scale. Allah says, فَمَنْ ثَقُلَتْ مَوَازِينُ, anyone whose scale is filled or is more heavier with good deeds, فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُفْلِحُونَ, they are the ones who are going to rejoice. Now let me guess among them. Then he says that وَمَنْ خَفَّتْ مَوَازِينُ, those whose deeds are not enough and make the bad deed to be more heavier than the good deeds, فَأُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ خَسِرُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ, Allah is saying that they are the ones who have cheated themselves. Why Allah is saying cheated? Because Allah has made everything plain. There is good and bad. And Allah didn't cease anyone from doing good and didn't cease anyone also from doing bad. So the choice is yours. Allah says, وَهَدَيْنَاهُ النَّجْدَيْنِ, we show you two paths, good and bad. So any of the paths that you choose, Allah allows you in. So you seek guidance from Allah. Due to that, we talk about the good deeds. What are good deeds? The first and most important of good deeds is the good deeds of your testification that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only one. You testify by your tongue and believe in your heart, and then you prove by working. What does that mean? You say these words, we all say La ilaha illallah every day. Then in your heart, is there La ilaha illallah or not? That's the problem. Somebody can make dua until he will say, Subhanallah, made dua. I don't see anything. Then shirk or doubt enters the heart. Satan is working. So your heart has to be 100% believing in what you have said with your tongue. Then we have those who say La ilaha illallah, they say, because if you say La ilaha illallah, you go to Jannah. They don't pray, they don't fast, they don't do any good deed. Sometimes they say we are even better than those who pray, because they pray and they do bad. Don't judge yourself because you cannot judge, and you don't judge others because you cannot judge. You have to look at the judge, who is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. So he say La ilaha illallah, he doesn't pray. La ilaha illallah, he doesn't fast. La ilaha illallah, he doesn't do what? Go to Hajj if he has money. It means it's La ilaha illallah, it's not correct. So La ilaha illallah have to be with the tongue, the heart, and also parts of your body. Then if this is complete, the ulama are saying that Allah is saying the good deed that Allah mentioned in the Quran means that you come on the day of judgment believing in the oneness of Allah. So if you do that, then you have the two rewards, the reward of Allah increasing every deed by 10, and the reward of Allah protecting you from the hellfire. So people are divided into three, as we mentioned, people of good deeds, they don't have bad deeds, and people of bad deeds, they don't have good deeds. The good go to Jannah and the bad go to hellfire. In between, like I mentioned, is where we belong. Our deeds are being weighed on the day of judgment. So since we know that the highest of all good deeds is the good deeds of testification of the presence of Allah, and then believing in your heart and putting it into action, the second of good deeds is that we obey Allah in what is more loving to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As Allah says in Al-Athar, مَا حَبَّ إِلَيَّ عَبَدِي that in Allah, nothing that Allah love, which His servant will do, that will please the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more than what He Allah has ordained unto you. What are they? 5 daily prayers. Fasting the Ramadan. Giving charity. And going to Hajj. 5 pillars of Islam. If you keep them, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam says you go to Jannah. So the second of good deeds, as we mentioned, is that the good deeds of you obeying Allah. Not to do some other good deeds and think that is more better. No. Nothing more better after believing in Allah than to make sujood. Nothing better than believing in Allah than to fast Ramadan. Nothing better than believing in Allah than to give zakah. And nothing than to go to Hajj. I give you an example. We pray, we fast, and so on. But when we come to Hajj, we have a problem. What is the problem? The person is young and he has money. He doesn't go to Hajj. Why? Because he said, inshallah, maybe when he grows old, as if Hajj is made for the old people. And who has guaranteed that you are going to grow old? When death can come on anyone at any time. Maybe he is a trader making business and he doesn't want to leave his business and go to Hajj. Why? Because he doesn't trust people who are working with him. Brother, whatever belongs to you shall come to you. Nothing will escape you. These are the words of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So with this all satanic thinking, he delays in going to Hajj. And maybe he died before the time. So since the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam says that within the 5 pillars of Islam, going to Hajj is optional, because if you don't have the means, or you are not healthy enough, or there is no security for you, then you are excused. But if you have all these things that are in place, then Hajj becomes obligatory on you, not optional again. That is why Ali bin Abi Talib explained this in a very simple sentence. That anyone who has the means, that means you can buy a ticket from your country to Mecca in and out, and have some money that you can be able to feed yourself while you are in Mecca, and then you have some money that you may leave behind for your family or for your children and so on, that they can feed till your return. Then again, you have security. That means on the way, you don't have anyone who is going to attack you. That's guaranteed because you go with plane. And thirdly, you are healthy. So if you have these three conditions and you don't go to Hajj and then die in that state, Ali ibn Abi Talib says, you die a Jew or a Christian. What does that mean? Because they are the ones who have refused to go to Hajj. So my brothers, those who Allah wants you to worship Him well when you are young and strong. Use the strength that Allah has given you in worshiping Allah. Not when you grow old. Because when you grow old, like to 60 years, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells the angels that He is feeling pity for His servant after 60 years. Now he's worshiping Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying that, oh my servant, I am feeling shy of you, so feel shy of me. When he attained 80 years old, Allah tells the angels, don't write in the bad deed that he has done. Because there's no strength to do bad deeds. You cannot go to the disco any longer. You cannot go and do bad things any longer. Then he starts saying the astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah, subhanallah. This is the time. There was a time in those days of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and Umar was going in the company of young boys. Then they arrived at a place where they had a very big gutter. And the gutter was so long and deep. They want to jump. Others say, we walk through, it's like a valley, and come out. They say, no, they have to jump. And this old man who was about 60 years old, went back and then ran and jumped over the gutter. And none of the young boys could do that. 20 years, 30 years, they couldn't do it. After that, they asked the old man, how could you do that? Then he said, these parts of my body, my hands, my feet, my eyes, my ears, all the parts of my body, I took care of them while I was young in worshiping Allah and protect them from committing sin. So now that I have grown old, Allah is taking protection of them. Today you see someone is young, 30 years, he's walking, and then the waist is crooked. He cannot even move. It happens to us all. Why? Because we have used these parts of our body in offending Allah. So Allah doesn't take care of them. So if you are strong now, it is time for you to go and perform the Hajj. Don't wait for no one. Wallahi, if you leave your trade, your business, Allah will take care of it. Believe in Allah and Allah will take care of it. Those days when I used to go to Sweden and make khutbah one day in the mosque. Before you enter the place to break wudu, I found a bundle of money. More than 5,000, I don't remember very well. And after prayer, we go to sit at the corner and then start making dars, meaning that learning. So I kept that money to see who would come for it. Then later on, an old man, like the age of my father, he came straight away and said, I left money over there and I'm coming for the money. Is the money with any of you? I said, yes, the money is with me. Then I asked him, how much? He told me exactly the total. And then I asked him, but father, why do you leave your money there? Don't you think someone can take it? He said, I was going to make wudu and I left the money there, not exposed, but in a place whereby someone could see. Then I asked him, didn't you fear that someone would take the money? He said, wallahi, no one would take it. I said, why? He said, because the money is halal. Subhanallah. And I learned from him, I will not put my money anyway. You get me? So these are people who are very, very strong in the heart. They have faith, more faith. People of the past, they are more strong in their belief in Allah than us today. A young boy in Saudi Arabia went to tell his father, father, I have a dalil. What is dalil? He said, I have dalil of 100 proofs that Allah exists. And the father doesn't know anything about Tawheed or anything. He cannot read Arabic. He says, son, where did you get this from? He said, from school. Then he said, the one who has taken all his time to look for 100 dalil, proofs, evidence that Allah exists, in the first place, he had 100 doubts in Allah. So today is different between us and them. So we do good deeds and then we get from Allah. And the last of good deeds is what you do voluntarily. You pray extra, you give extra sadaqah, you go to Hajj extra, you give extra zakah. Allah says, if you do this, you do that until He loves you. And if Allah loves you, Allah will protect you from head to toe. Then if we talk of bad deeds, the most and worst of all bad deeds is to make shirk. Joining partners with Allah. Today we don't have people worshipping idols, but they are making shirk. Why? Because the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, it is not a big shirk that I fear for you, but a hidden shirk. They ask him, what is a hidden shirk? He said, Riya, that you do something for people to say, Mashallah. Someone will come on the day of judgment, he make jihad, he want hasanat. No hasanat for you. Why? Because you want people to say you are Rambo, you are brave. They have said it, your hasanat is over. Someone will come, I made sadaqa, and they will say, you made sadaqa because you want people to say you are generous, and they have said it. Someone will care, I'll come, I made salah. You made salah because you want people to say that, mashallah, you are a good Muslim, and they have said it, and it's over. Like today, this man will say, mashallah, I'm on the sunnah, I'm salafi, and this man is shirk, and this and that. When he wants to make salah, he sits the stand, and they say, Allahu Akbar. So that people will hear and ask him or something like that. And he thinks that he is more than any everyone. Ibn al-Qayyim al-Jawziyyah says that sometimes the hasanat or the iman of a person will send him to hellfire, and sometimes someone's sin will send him to Jannah. They ask him why. He said because sometimes someone becomes more strong in his iman. Then he sees everyone to be down. No one is like him. Then he becomes arrogant. Anywhere he talks, he speaks anyhow, walks arrogantly, treat people arrogantly. And then the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, anyone who has an atom weight of pride, atom weight that you cannot even see of pride, arrogance in him, will not enter Jannah. Then he says that, but the one who is committing sin, he knows he is a sinner. But always he's saying, Ya Rab, Ya Rab, Ya Rab. He will go and commit a sin again, but he's still knowing that he has a Lord. And Allah says, if my servant comes to me on the day of judgment with the side of this earth, sin and does not associate partners with me will enter Jannah. So he says that the person who is committing sin and always saying, Ya Allah, Ya Allah, Ya Allah, he said one day the malaika will say Amen, and his everything is over, and Allah will allow him to be a pilgrim again. Brothers and sisters in Islam, let's try to practice our religion in the way that Allah has commanded us, and never do any deed unless it goes in line with the teachings of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And let's not compare ourselves to anyone and try to be better than anyone. Compare yourself with your own self. If yesterday you were not praying well, try to pray well today, so that today you compare with yesterday. Am I stronger today than yesterday? How much Quran do I read? Did I read any Quran yesterday? I didn't read. Today I read maybe 3 verses. Tomorrow I have to read 4 verses. Compare yourself with yourself. Don't think about people. If you do that, then Allah will make you better as they pass by. May Allah strengthen our hearts. May Allah make us good Muslims. May Allah accept all our good deeds. May Allah forgive us our bad deeds. And may Allah make our parents who are dead to be in Jannah, those who are still alive to be doors of paradise for their children. May Allah bless our children. May Allah guide them onto the straight path. Those who are all along having problems with their children, may Allah secure the problems for them. Those who have problems with their wife,